Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be creating this realistic reflecting glass surface. The complete design is in vector form, that is, it is prepared inside Illustrator without using any stock image. We'll be following very simple steps to get this effect. Our main option which we'll be using here is the gradient option tool. So let's begin with the designing process. The first thing we'll create is the base of the design. So, open a new Illustrator document and draw a rectangle using the rectangle tool. Then apply a gradient color and add some color sliders to give a 3D feel. Add two sliders on left, two sliders on right, and one in the middle. Double click on the corner sliders and this will open a panel. Here, change the color mode to RGB and apply gray color using the color code #666E75. Copy the same color code and apply it on the other corner as well. Now for the second slider, we'll give deep blue color. And lastly, use the color code #001F33 to give a dark blue color. Now edit the sliders to give a proper cylindrical look. The light color applied on both sides is going to be used as highlights. Next, we're going to add the gloss effect, or you can say the reflection to the surface. So we'll draw out a vertical line using the line segment tool. Apply white color and increase the stroke thickness to around 42 points. Then we'll change the profile to this option. This will give us a nice broad area and pointed corners on both sides. Now we'll do some adjustments with the stroke. So using the width tool, increase the thickness of the upper region. Just click and drag where you want to give or add thickness. Let's make the end little bit rounded. Now convert this into outline object using the expand appearance option. Next, if you observe a reflection on a real glass bottle, you notice that their reflection edges are a little noisy due to the surface texture of the bottle. To give that effect to our design, we'll use the wrinkle tool from our toolbar. To adjust the attributes, double click on the wrinkle tool and here we'll change the horizontal to 100% and vertical to 0%. What it does is that when you apply the effect, it will apply it horizontally. Let's increase the strength a little bit more and the intensity to 10%. Now if you apply it, you can see a nice wrinkle effect along the edges. Give more wrinkles to the ends compared to the middle regions. Now, we'll duplicate few more of these shapes and place them like these. Now the next step is to apply gradient color. So select the shape and apply gradient color. Add a slider in the center and give light blue color with the color code #C3D4F0. Add two more sliders on the other ends. Apply the color code #BACAE7 to one of it and #717695 for dark tone to the corner. Apply the same color sliders on the other side as well. For the second shape, apply dark blue color on both sides and also copy the same color for the last shape using the eye picker tool. Next, we're going to create the sticker for the bottle. So draw a rectangle using the rectangle tool, then make the points round by dragging the circular icon inwards. Now to give a cylindrical effect, apply gradient color. For this, we'll set the center color black and the corner two sliders gray color. Edge the sliders to give a cylindrical effect. Also, edge the gradient of our main rectangle to make the edge glow thinner. Next, we're gonna add the alphabet icon and the text to the sticker. So type out the alphabet and scale up the size. Let's choose a bold font. So apply Britannic bold font and place it at the top left corner. After this, to mask out the extended regions, create a duplicate of the rectangular shape using the shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Then arrange it to front. Now select the rectangle and the alphabet and apply Make Clipping Mask. This way the alphabet icon will be visible only inside the rectangular shapes. Next, type out a title with a small font size. Give Britannic bold for the thick fonts and Bodoni 72 for the thin font style. We'll use the color combination of white and red. Also scale up the size to fit the size of the label. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to create the outline for the design. So first of all, select all the elements of the design and group it up. Then draw a rectangle same size of the artboard on top and apply make clipping mask. This way you can decide which portion of the bottle you want to showcase. Now double click inside and let's give a slight angular rotation to the shape. This will add a dynamic look to the composition. Let's reposition the shapes which are used for giving a realistic reflection. These wrinkle effects which we have added to these shapes are making the design more believable. We can also add one more step to this designing process, that is, if you add a texture to these shapes like grains and change the grain type to vertical with intensity to around 53 and the contrast to 63, then we'll get a nice vertical grain effect on the surface. By adding these small details, you can see the difference, how realistic it looks even in the close-ups. Lastly, to add a little depth, we'll apply inner glow to the icon. We'll use the black color with normal color mode, opacity to 29% and the blur value to 15 points. You can also use different alphabetical icons for the design by just replacing the text. Finally, we have completed designing a realistic reflecting glass surface in Illustrator. The techniques used are very simple and easy to follow. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.